If you're looking to send information from ClickUp to other users who maybe aren't in ClickUp, previously you only had a few options. You could either share a public view, kind of giving you a snapshot of ClickUp that you can't interact with, or you could export to Excel and hope that people can make sense of the kind of ugly ClickUp exports, or you could do the kind of janky method of taking a screenshot of a dashboard and sending that via an email. None of these options were particularly great, which is why I'm so excited about the new email feature that ClickUp has rolled out. Now, to be clear, this email from ClickUp feature isn't perfect, but what I'm going to show you today is what is released in the beta release of this feature. What is this feature able to do today? Understanding the fact that there's going to be new features, including automations for email, coming out in the very near future, maybe by the time you're watching this. I'm also going to give you an example of how a service or field request kind of business could use this feature to communicate with clients from ClickUp directly without having to open emails in another tab. And just to introduce the talking head on your screen, my name is Layla. I'm a ClickUp consultant and process geek, and I help people learn how to use ClickUp. So as I'm going through today, if you're feeling yourself getting a little overwhelmed with all the ClickUp features, you're not sure where to start, you feel like you're using ClickUp in a much more basic way than what's possible, you might want to check out ClickUp Community, link in the description below, but that's how I mainly work with clients to help them get their ClickUp up and running much faster. All right, on with the video. So to get started with email from ClickUp, we need to actually set it up. So let's go into ClickUp right now, and I'll show you exactly how to do that. So first, we need to make sure that the ClickApp for emails from ClickUp is turned on. You can do this by going into the bottom left corner and going to your ClickApp settings. So when you're in your settings, you can click on ClickApps, and you'll actually see all the different ClickApps and features ClickUp has. ClickApps, if you're not familiar, are ClickUp's way of making the interface modular. So by turning some of these off, some of the more complex features will be hidden. And whenever ClickUp releases a new feature, they typically release it as a ClickApp, meaning it's not on for everybody. You actually need to turn it on to get that feature. That ensures that they're not overcomplicating the system with features that you don't need. So here we can see the email from ClickUp feature. I can actually toggle this on, and it'll ask me where exactly I want this feature to be enabled. I'm actually going to turn it on all of my spaces, meaning every single space I have in ClickUp will allow me to send emails directly from ClickUp. I also have an important setting here that I want to make sure we're calling some attention to, which is the posted replies to emails as threaded replies instead of new comments. This basically means if you have an email exchange, do you want every single email to be its own comment in ClickUp, or do you want those responses to be threaded using ClickUp's threaded comments feature? Personally, I prefer to see people keep the threaded comments on. That keeps everything more condensed and consolidated, much like you would be used to in Slack. Now, I think this will make a little bit more sense if we actually demo the email feature. So let's pop back into our space and let's actually try it out. So now we're here back in ClickUp. And if I click on any task where I have that ClickApp enabled, remember I enabled it in every space, so that should mean every task should have this. I now see an extra little option when I go to comment, and it says send email. If I click on this kind of upward caret, it'll switch into email mode from ClickUp. And this is where the really cool stuff happens. From here, I can set a to address, which is anyone, whether or not they're in ClickUp, a subject line, and the actual message I'd like to send as an email. I can also add my own email signature and use email templates. Now, a note, at the time of recording, add a file is an option, but there is a known bug right now with the new email feature that images and files are not being sent properly. So this is kind of the thing with ClickUp and their new features. Just bear with them. This will get fixed. I'm fully confident that it will. But at the time of recording, this is not fully functional. In order to actually use this email feature, though, we need a little bit more prep done for our workspace. We actually need to link the email address that's going to be sending the email, if that makes sense. If we click on link an email, it's actually going to prompt you in the modal to connect an email account to ClickUp. As you can see, it includes all of the common options you would expect when it comes to connecting your email. In my case, I'm going to choose to connect my Google account. Give them permission to see the access that they need to see. Click allow. Once it finishes connecting with my email account, the permissions are all good. It's going to then ask me who should have access to this email account. Now, this is a pretty cool feature and an exciting thing to see in the very first version of this feature. Basically, I can now allow other people to send from that email account. See what I'm saying? So it's kind of like delegated email access. Since workspaces can only connect a certain number of email accounts, I would highly recommend whatever email account you connect be your general team email account, at least as one of the options. So maybe support@processdriven.co or info@ or hello@ or team@, rather than a personal individual, because if you use a more general email account, you can delegate that access like you're seeing here and allow other people to also use it. And yes, you can indeed choose specific people to give the permission to email from this email address. In this example, I'm going to go with all members being able to access this. All right, clicking done. Hey, quick reminder, if you're still enjoying this video, please do give it a thumbs up. It helps this video perform in the YouTube algorithm, and I would really appreciate it. All right, back to the video. Now, here we get into the actual templating area for email settings. First of all, we see our email accounts, and look, we can add additional ones based on the account that you have. Signatures are your email signatures. You can actually add multiple different email signatures depending on what kind of voice you want to have. Who do you want to have this sound like it's coming from? I've copied mine in directly from Google here, and you'll notice that when I actually preview it, it does lose a lot of its formatting. So I would recommend working in HTML if you have that option to make sure that your stuff actually looks really nice from email. This is just one of those things that, once again, I think they're going to work on over time, but right now the email signatures aren't so pretty. They're very basic. Next up is templates, and in templates, like you expected, you can create email templates. But overall, the creation of the email template is as simple as giving it a nickname, which is your internal name for the template, the subject line, the actual email content, and who is going to have access to that template. And as you can see here, I have chosen to highlight certain words in yellow just to make sure that whoever's sending the email notices them, but these are not dynamic fields. They do not allow us to pull in, say, hello, first name, like you would expect on an email newsletter tool or many other template options. As of this time, these templates are entirely manual, and when you're writing the template and editing the template, it is entirely manual. So anyway, there is our template center. We're going to exit out of this, and let's go back to writing that actual email. So we can type in the to address manually, give it a subject line, or again, if we want to skip all this work, let's just use the template we already have. It's going to pull in all the information, and we can manually change the things we want to manually change before we click send email. As you can see, we just sent an email from ClickUp. It is that easy. It's as simple as writing a comment, but it actually sends an email to someone outside of ClickUp. Now, notice that right here, there is the reply to email button, and this is where the threads come in. If I were to click reply to email, I would be able to actually send another email, again, in a threaded response so that they're all kind of combined. If I were to just click comment here, it would make an internal note, which can be really nice for internal delegation of tasks inside the email thread. So this is a comment internally. If I wanted to send another email, I could just go ahead and do that here. And it would all kind of nest together in one long conversation in one place that we could see the whole log of conversations in one spot. Now, I've already kind of given you a bit of a teaser on this, but I just want to show you how this would work in a practical application. So in this list, I created a service request. This is kind of a simplified IT request area that is based on locations. I built this form that you could then embed in your website. And if we actually preview this form, we see something like this. So with this form, which we could embed anywhere, someone can submit a request for service. So let's just go ahead and fill one out. So we've submitted a request, which again, we're doing this in the preview mode, but this is working just the same as if we shared this link with somebody else or put this link on our website. Because we submitted a form in ClickUp, it created a new task, and I have all of my new things showing up in this filtered view called new request. When this comes in, our dispatch person in this fake service company would look at it, check the details, obviously not a very good detailed request, and check the address, and then assign it to a representative. We have a simple automation set up here that once you assign it to the representative, here you can actually see the automation, then we have it change the status automatically into the active status, which takes it out of this main area here. Now, of course, ClickUp automations require a bit of a delay, so let's go ahead and refresh our screen to make sure that this takes effect. So here you can see upon refresh, that task actually left this area because of the automation and because of the fact that I have this area filtered to just show me the new request. So if I pop over to active, I will actually see that ticket there. Now, this obviously isn't showing you the email feature, so let's get into that part. If we have this kind of example here, this is a request that came in that we want to have resolved, we can go in here and send our standard email, which might be part of our dispatch process. Maybe once we actually assign someone to this request, we will use our email template to notify the customer. So to do this, we're going to go into the comments, click send email, type in the customer's email, and rather than typing the subject and the body from scratch, once again, we're going to use our email templates. Here we can have a bunch of different ones created, but I already created one for having the technician assigned, so we're just going to use that one here. Like I talked about before, we're going to want to replace these fields with the actual information. So technician Layla is going to arrive at 1:30 in the afternoon. Please reply to this email to confirm. There we go. I actually included a brief signature, if you will, in the template itself, so I'm not going to go ahead and add a signature, and I'm going to send that email. All right, now just for fun, I know you wouldn't normally get to see this, I'm actually going to go into Gmail and show you what this email looks like from the client's perspective. So here you can actually see the email from the client side. This is what it looks like. I have it sending from me because I'm in the address book of the person already, and it's sending to the client's email address, and it sent the information exactly as we saw. And the actual bottom portion, which this is actually a little bit strange, actually shows up below the signature fold. That's actually a little strange. Okay, this one, the first one, came in normally, so maybe I shouldn't worry about it too much. But there you go, that's what it looks like. And as the customer, I can actually choose to respond to this email to put my information back into the ClickUp thread. So I'm just gonna go ahead and type a quick response. Now, you can see this gets a little confusing because all of the email addresses are mine, so let's just go check out ClickUp to see what it all looks like together. Okay, so now that we've responded as the client, right, we can see this response come into ClickUp. And on the right side, I'll see the email that we sent, which, by the way, we can see how many times it was viewed, who's following this email, meaning who's a watcher, and even the email itself here, which is kind of cool. But if we scroll down just a little bit, we'll see that there's actually some replies that have come through for this email, because I've been responding to it as the client to see what would happen. Going to the replies area, we'll actually see that the client, which is also me, responded and the ClickBot pulled in that response and put it into ClickUp itself. Now notice there's actually two responses here. That's my bad, not ClickUp's bad. I just responded twice because I was getting impatient. Now we can choose at this point to make an internal note, like a comment like this one, or we can choose to again respond via email. If we post a comment, it's not going to be sent out to the client. It's just an internal note, which is really, really helpful. If we want to respond to the client or even email anyone else, we can then go into here and once again, send an email using ClickUp. So today we talked about how to send emails from ClickUp. This is the beta feature of ClickUp. There are a lot more features coming to this feature, meaning they're going to kind of improve this feature, if you will. Things like being able to automate emails, and I wouldn't be surprised to also see dynamic fields coming very soon. But notice this is email from ClickUp. You can also send emails into ClickUp, and I made a whole separate video about that up here. Now, I typically avoid covering new features, as you guys know if you follow the channel for a while, but I think this feature is one that is quite usable even in its beta form. I'd love to hear, for those of you watching, are you using this feature? And if so, how are you using it? Kind of similar to what I'm talking about here, or have you created your own kind of use case? For me personally, I imagine this is gonna be really handy for customer service requests, which is kind of why I pulled this example, but also for any client relationship where you don't wanna have the client in ClickUp itself. But anyway, I think that's it for this tutorial. I hope this was valuable to you guys. If you did enjoy this even a little bit, I'd appreciate a thumbs up, leave a comment, say hi, subscribe, all those good things. Those actions cost you nothing and help this video reach more people. But until next time, enjoy the process.